I'm very happy to be here this afternoon. And right at the outset, let me express my heartfelt congratulations and appreciation to the entire team, both on the stage and each one of you who has made this event, as he said, more and more successful from year one, year two, and now we are in the edition number three. And I think when I heard them that there are parallel sessions going on, one on intensive care, one more on women in hospital, and then one more on hospital management, women in medical and healthcare, and then this general one as well. I'm very happy that this is something which was and which is, I think, badly needed. Because it's often said that when you play any game or when you are engaged in any work, the daily demands of your work, the firefighting, the kind of work pressures that you have, they probably engage and take up all of your attention and so on. And the processes, while you're doing it, there would be a lot of learning on the margins that you would have had. But you every now and then need a little pause. If you're playing a game of badminton, I think every now and then you need to just hold the shuttlecock in your hand and figure out, where am I headed? How is the game headed? I think this little space and time to reflect on how are we doing things, can we do it better, how can it be done more efficiently, in a manner that touches, has greater impact. And that's where technology too comes in. And so I'm extremely happy that Hitcon, when I heard the word Hitcon, it almost sounded like Bitcoin, and I was, it's just a, and I do hope this Hitcon is a big hit, just as, but that doesn't dip down, like Bitcoin goes up sometimes and comes down. Let's hope that this soars higher and higher, and that we really create these spaces, and as just now, as was suggested by Dr. Pragnesh, if we can also have these events, not just as a one-off event once in a year, ke jya aapne badha mariye chhe, we all meet together, adan pradan thai chhe, ane pachi aapne jata rahiye, evu na bane. Is it also possible that since Venture Studio and a lot of young people are also here, can we identify 4 or 5 strands of problems that really touch the lives of all of us here? And ema jo apne kahi breakthroughs male, if that, I think, could be a great contribution of Hitcon. So each year, instead of aiming for, you know, 20 things or 30 things, if we just chose 2 or 3 key issues which we thought we could try, and in our own small way, but using the strengths of the entire, jene apne IT ma padhave, IT bhasha ma crowdsourcing kahiye che, we've seen how many elegant design solutions have been created end to end just with the power of people. How many of you have traveled and used Airbnb? Anybody here? Chalo, I'll make it easier. How many of you have used Uber or Ola? Now, isn't it? So these things probably a few years back were unimaginable. I'm sure all of you have Facebook and Twitter. Even this is a testimony of all of this. So how can we see all this really penetrating into and making our operations even more efficient, effective, so that your free time, you're not required to do those repetitive processes, tasks, and activities which don't really require constant thinking. So your energy, your time, your ideas could be then cleared up for those issues, problems that really require an application of your mind. So I think something like this is certainly a very smart way of doing things. And I'd like to congratulate Hitcon and the entire team, all of you. I had a few things that I too wanted to share. I think this is a very historic opportunity. This is an inflection point, if I may say, in the development of our country and the world as well. So with technology and IT now being reasonably well settled, application across different fields has become a very, very common way of life. Penetration of mobiles, tablets, computers, it's almost ubiquitous. Jahan par jao, people have access to all of these gadgets, equipment. And therefore, now with this whole movement that is called Jandhan accounts, so the bank accounts, digitization, Aadhaar card and mobile technology, which was the acronym coined for it was JAM, Jandhan, Aadhaar and mobiles. With this, it's a great opportunity for us to see how we can intelligently utilize, mine all this data that is being collected and gather some few very interesting insights. If we can dip into it and figure out, do some data mining and understand what and forecast maybe, looking at IDSP, which are the diseases on the horizon that I see erupting? Where are they happening? What can I do so that we mitigate our response time and the impact of such adverse events that occur? Can we be better prepared? And instead of running helter-skelter and sort of dissipating our energy in acting in a very ineffective manner or inefficient manner, if we had these smart ways of gauging ki kya mare attack karvanu che, where is the problem, and can I just go there, have surveillance there and ensure this is done, I think this would be a great tool for us all. I'd like to also share a few things that our department has done, and I'm very happy that we have Dr. Dhodakia here. Dhodakia sahab, can I request you to stand up? We'd like to appreciate and give him a big round of applause. 108. How many of you have heard of the number 108? If somebody hasn't, which world are you living in? Huh? So he has been one of the pioneers of this for the last 10 years, who has made this happen. It was a dream. And Gujarat was perhaps the first state in India where the government took up full support, and today we have a very thriving, active implementation rollout of 108. That's one example. Thank you, Dhodakia sahab. Similarly, he's the one who takes care of technology in our office. And the second, I would say, very popular scheme, and which again is an example of public-private partnership, is the Mukhyamantri Amritam Yojana, Ma Yojana. So this was again an effort where we thought if we can actually codify the types of transactions, the types of interventions, diseases, illnesses, and also have a kind of tariff which helps deal with the huge volumes and also at a cost which makes the government, you know, place its money in an efficient manner, because after all, this is the taxpayers' money. So can we have access to health opened up for everybody? Access to provide services for all of you also opened up, provided you fulfill the criteria that is required and make this demand and supply meet. And that too has been enabled completely using IT. So we've got these cards, MA cards, which are a big hit, very popular. Very soon we're also planning to integrate this with Aadhaar so that you get access to all the demographic data very easily. And if this data is available on the cloud, now we talk of IoT, Internet of Things and so on, in the event of any emergency accident, you don't have to go around. So when those platinum hours, gold hours or whatever, when you have that crisis of time, you don't have to then go about figuring out, checking the blood group. Everything is immediately available. So these are the kind of elegant, relevant solutions that I think this team could also think about further developing and rolling out. Another initiative, new initiative that we've done, and we invite all of you to also dip into it and utilize it for making all these services available, is this concept of a health atlas. We've done an extensive GIS mapping of which are the diseases. For example, we have the Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakram, which is again a phenomenal intervention by the government. I'm sure all of you know, but then at the risk of repeating this, this is an effort that the government of India has rolled out where every child from the age of 0 to 18, we're actually screening it for various deformities, developmental delays, deficiencies, and what is the fourth D? Disabilities. We want you to be aware there are four Ds that we check. Right? So the moment we get to know that here is a child with this disability or this problem, we ensure that we again have access to various providers, service providers, health service providers, for example, cochlear transplant and things like that. And I have been a witness and seen many children whose lives have got cleft lip, for example, just about 2 weeks ago. I was at Shamlaji, and where is, we just met a gentleman, doctor from, so you have, we had this whole camp for cleft lip. So we've seen in the past children who grow up into adults, senior citizens with this condition, and their own confidence, acceptability by society, and then your own right to lead a dignified life is also a little compromised. But then with this intervention, which is done right at a very young age, within a matter of a few years, you find that all these children are able to now get very nicely integrated with the mainstream and lead a life full of confidence without having any sense of, you know, feeling small, inferior, and so on. These are some examples. Another very promising effort that has just been rolled out, in fact, this pilot was going on with the help of another very, very active community-based organization in Gujarat, and I'm sure you've all heard of this organization. This is a couple, Dr. Anil Bhai and Lata Ben. Have you heard of their names? Of Seva Rural in Jhagadia. How many of you have heard of this organization? And if you haven't, I would say Hitcon must. One of the hit applications that they have done is something called I Am Teko. This was developed in the year 2013, originally started around 2007-8. And this has tremendously transformed the lives of the health workers and, of course, the final end beneficiaries in places which are literally like the back of beyond, like talukas, like Jhagadia, and so on. So you now have an Asha. Asha is, of course, you all know, she's our grassroots health worker. The acronym is Accredited Social Health Activist. Itle apni je Asha behno chhe. They carry a simple mobile, and the entire scheduling, ke aje savare kya javano, kona ghare javano, who has to be given an injection, which is the follow-up, which is the home-based newborn care, all those tasks appear on her mobile. I'm not sure all of us use a daily tasking, you know, scheduler for doing our jobs, but the Asha gets it. Not only that, everything that she's, you know, conducting, carrying out, they immediately gets reflected. Her incentive is also calculated. And this effort, the acronym was Technology Enabled Community Health Operations, TECO. So when Honorable Prime Minister launched it, he said, "A TECO che." And TECO in Gujarati, you all know, that's a pillar, a support. And so I think that's the spirit in which we are trying to see how we can fold in, engage, and leverage IT for all these operations. And here I'm very happy that we're all collectively working here. Just to conclude, I would say that this is an enormous power that we have, this group, this collectivity, and collectivity of people who really belong to the top cohort of society, isn't it? Why did you get into medicine? What made you get in? Several factors, right? The first factor, I want all of us sitting here to, and those listening to us elsewhere, to for a moment go back to the time we were really young, probably a young child at home. Maybe you were trying to treat something or heal a little mosquito bite or a wound that your grandmother had. And she saw you and she said, "Ah, barak to moto thaine amaru dikro, doctor thai shakshe." Or if you were playing with a mechanical instrument, and if you were really good at it, she might have said, maybe you were fixing a car or a Lego, she might have said, "Ah, moto thaine, shubanshe, engineer." So sometimes these little seeds which are sown in your childhood, they really ignite your imagination, isn't it? And that is what makes us aspire. And wouldn't it be great if young children across the length and breadth of Gujarat, if we ignite them with these dreams that tame mota thaine, would you like to be a doctor? Seva bhav sathe, with compassion, can you transform the lives of people? Wouldn't it be great if they have you all as role models who belong to this noble profession, rather than just, I'm not against any category of people, rather than just having maybe Deepika Padukone and Shah Rukh Khan as role models alone, or Katrina Kaif. I'm not against any profession, but I'm saying, can we not have them develop more wholesome ideas of what is it that they would like to do when they grow up? So it's in that spirit too that we are now trying to have an effort of trying to have one child in each class. We're just calling him or her a child health monitor or a child a bal doctor. So this has been a little misunderstood and misinterpreted. I wanted to clarify it here, and I think we're all responsible people and we'll understand it. The idea is ridiculous to imagine that this little child is going to replace any of you seated here. That's absolutely not the idea. But the idea is that can this child go home and talk about nutrition? And when a child goes and asks its mother, thodu hatagrah pan kare, ke mare saragvani bhaji, mare lila bhaji pan tu khavadavje, I think it will have an impact, won't it? If the child goes home and tells the mother, I need a toilet at home, and I want all of us to use a toilet, I don't want open defecation, kemke khula ma shauch karva thi, mandgi vade che, infant mortality vade che, etc., etc., don't you think there couldn't be a more powerful way of bringing about what is called social and behavioral change? Because that's needed. Ekla a moti je ladai che, ladai against poor health or the ills that we have, whether it's poor hygiene, poor malnutrition, whether it's maternal deaths, infant deaths, a badha mate aje ladai che. Ema ekla tame ane hu. લડીએ તો એમાં કંઈ સફળતા મળી જવાનું છે એવું નથી. વી નીડ ધી એન્ટાયર સોસાયટી ઓલ્સો ટુ ઓન ઓલ ઓફ ધીઝ. એન્ડ ઇફ ધીઝ ચિલ્ડ્રન કેન ઓલ્સો ટેક કેર દેટ ધીઝ ગુજરાત એન્ડ આઈ એમ શ્યોર મેની પાર્ટ્સ ઓફ ઇન્ડિયા ઓલ્સો હેવ ધીસ પ્રોબ્લેમ ઓફ ટોબેકો ચ્યુઈંગ. એન્ડ ઇટ્સ અ પિટી આઈ હેવ સીન ચિલ્ડ્રન એઝ યંગ એઝ યુ નો સિક્સ સ્ટેન્ડર્ડ, ફોર્થ સ્ટેન્ડર્ડ ઓલ્સો ટેકિંગ ધીઝ પડીકાઝ. એન્ડ વેન એવર વી કમ અક્રોસ ઇટ, ઓફકોર્સ વી ટ્રાય ટુ ટ્રિગર ધેમ, explain to them the ill effects, even if required, probably even admonish it and make sure that this doesn't happen. But the problem is a little widespread. So if we can get all these young bal doctors or basically leaders in every class to tell their friends these simple messages about nutrition, immunization, you know, not that they're going to go and administer a dose, ridiculous, but can we not get the children to talk about these things? So I think we would like all of us to collectively take these messages forward to bring about a kind of revolution in the way mindsets, thinking of people ought to change, so that people also decide to have a more healthy and a more wholesome lifestyle. Aaje joiye to which is the biggest killer other than natural causes of deaths in our country too? Tell me. Ischemic heart diseases, that's the number one killer. And so what does it reflect?
Lifestyle
problems. So we need to change that. We need to have addressed these issues, because if there is an 85% of the population which is reasonably okay but heading towards that 15% which is morbid, I don't think we need to keep pushing more and more people into the 15. We need to see if we can prevent it. The size of the pie anyway is huge. There's enough work for all of us sitting here. But can we improve the quality and ensure that our energies are kept a little intact for those that genuinely need? There are people, notwithstanding all of this, who have serious and severe complications. To ena mate apni facilities rahe jethi ki aap bija loko je normal life lifestyle ma sudharo karva thi, some more of practices like yoga, better nutrition, better sleep. So we are very happy that we are involving people like Dr. Ramesh Kapadia as well, who has been championing this cause of things like universal healing program. So if we can bring in these other wellness, health and wellness as a concept, so that we ensure that the general quality lifestyle of quality of lifestyle improves, I think it would be a great step forward. And finally, I think this is a great opportunity today. As we said, this sector has a lot of diverse issues, and the fact is also that we now have reached a stage where we need to give choices to people. Kemke have apne koi pan ek jagah jaiye, khawa jaiye ki dukan ma jaiye. If you look at just this room, we're all wearing different colors, different textures of clothes, isn't it? Why? That's because everybody has, even a little child would have its choice and ideas. So if we were to have a more democratic approach in terms of giving people choices, and also, of course, we should also leverage this demographic dividend that India has. And now in the health sector, I would also appeal that we should also leverage the longevity dividend, isn't it? Atyare apna tya average life, the longevity has also increased. So those people technically who have even gone beyond the age of serving in government, etc., if they can also be leveraged to be very active members in the provision of health facilities, I think we would make a big difference. So once again, often in government, I sit with our colleagues and say that we are grappling with rice cultivation. Why do I say that? Because apne dangar nu khetir kariye, the scale is huge. But often all of you, when you're dealing with tasks, you have the privilege sometimes of doing what is called rose cultivation, gulab ni kheti. Kimke the size and scale and the niche that you're working in is smaller. But with IT, with telemedicine, even telesurgery, I mean, all these seem like impossible things from where we are today. But very soon, many of these things are beginning to happen, maybe in small ways, in small pockets. But it could become a mainstream practice, just as we have seen IT storming our lives in so many sectors. Ane e dishama java mate, I think IT and Hitcon, with the efforts of this team, and of course with design and all of this, this collective energy that we need to harness, not let it fritter away with meaningful, meaningless, you know, things that we debate about, which are not really taking us anywhere. But arite, collectively, if we harness, I think we can, this is an opportunity to convert rice cultivation into a huge rose cultivation. So it'll be like tulip farms that you see in Holland. પણ એ રીતે સરસ આપણે ડાંગરની ખેતીમાં પણ ગુલાબની ખેતીની જે એક સટીકતા હોય છે, એક આપણે ધીરે રહીને એક એક વસ્તુને જે ધ્યાનપૂર્વક જોઈ શકે, એવું માસ સ્કેલમાં પણ આટલી માઇક્રો ઝીણવટ પૂરતું કામ જો કરી શકીએ તો હું માનું છું એક મોટી અને સારી ઉપલબ્ધિ રહેશે. તો ફરી આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ કન્વે માય બેસ્ટ વિશીસ એન્ડ કંગ્રેચ્યુલેટ ધી ઓર્ગનાઇઝર્સ ઓલ ઓફ યુ એન્ડ હોપ that we're waiting for these 2-3 nice gifts from Hitcon. Betran Saras Design Solutions. We have all of us. We'll be more than happy. Our team, Dr. Gandhi, Dhurakya Saab, Dr. Shailesh Bhai Sutaria, they're all here. And our entire health team will be very happy to pilot some of these efforts and help people come and study these problems. Anejem Stanford University, vagera ma thai che. We really look at end-to-end solutions. They call it a design thinking. So they don't start teaching you a subject, but they say problem laine, problem no solution end to end karjo. To ema badha alag alag vishayo nu samavesh thai jatu hoy che. I'm also very happy, I'm told we have a very distinguished guest today from the national portal who has handled it in the past. So we also want to request you to see how we can leverage and see integration issues with our health data and CDAC, and we have so many other players. So here's again an invitation to all of you. Let's collectively work together and make a difference. Thank you.